Hello, in this video I'm going to show you in Visual Studio Code how to use PlantUML. We're going to be making use of the PlantUML extension in Visual Studio Code. I'm showing it to you right now. It's called PlantUML. It has a lot of users and it has 5 stars, and I like this plugin a lot. So let's get started. I've created a blank folder called PlantUML Tutorial, and I've opened that folder in Visual Studio Code. And we're just going to start by creating a simple document. We'll call it sequence.plantuml. PlantUML is the extension that the plugin in Visual Studio Code will recognize. So we'll start off with the standard sequence of PlantUML, which is start UML. I can use code completion to complete my document. I will also look at the syntax, and it will tell me that this document is unnamed, and so that means I need to really give a name to the document. It's optional to give this name, but it's useful. So we'll call it Hello World for a name. And then I'm just going to show you the end sequence, the end syntax, end UML, which is also recognized here. I'll take the code completion. So basically every PlantUML document starts off with start UML and end UML with the at signs at the beginning. So let's do a sequence diagram. There's the object A sending to the object B the message hello. And the editor is okay with the syntax. I will show you the feature where you can see what this diagram looks like, because that's the best part about UML, is it's visual. The show preview option shows me a preview of my diagram, and I can actually modify it in real time. Hello world. And the preview will update even without saving. So that's pretty cool. So I'll show you some options here in skin parameter. Skinparam is an option you can use to change the look of your diagram. So one of the features I prefer is not to see the objects at the bottom of the diagram, because that's sort of not the strictest form of UML. So what I'm going to use is the style option, style, and there's a configuration called strict UML, which is basically saying keep it classic in terms of the format of the UML. So now you don't see the objects at the bottom of the diagram. Let's do something else. We'll add a message from B to A. A return message that says hi, and you can see it's updated. You might notice that these messages are aligned at the left side of the arrows, and I want them to be centered. I will show you how to do that. Skin param. And if you forget what the syntax is, the cool thing about the plugin is you can say, okay, it's something with messages. So I'll type the word message. And I see a list of options. And I'm going to scroll down to take the one that says sequence message alignment. And I want it to be centered. So now you see that the messages are centered over the arrows. That's kind of a cool style. So we'll save this. Let's look at another option. A feature that you can do is export your current diagram. We're going to export this, and what's going to happen is it's going to create a diagram in a file, because this is just a preview. This is actually going to create a file in your project that's called helloworld.png. Now you'll note here that the name of your diagram was used for the name of the file. So helloworld.png is coming from the hello world here. If I click on that, I will see that it's a PNG file. And PNG files are bitmapped, so you will lose a little bit of detail in your diagrams when you zoom in. Whereas the preview will show you that it's actually a vector format. So PlantUML supports both vector and bitmap formats. There's also GIF and JPEG. So let's see another feature here you could use that could be useful is to generate a URL for your current diagram. And this feature is useful if you're using GitHub. I'm going to tell it to use SVG as the format. And what it did here is it generated a URL inside of a markdown for an image. So if you know markdown from GitHub README files, markdown has a very simple syntax to show an image. And this is what the tool generates for you. So you could actually copy this, you could copy this markdown snippet and paste it inside your README file in GitHub to show this diagram. And it's actually what I do for a lot of my courses. Okay, so I hope this is useful to you, this little tutorial. I'm going to be doing some other videos to show how to do different diagrams in PlantUML. So thanks for watching.